I'm doing a piece on the technicians who work in the private space industry. I had heard about this accident that happened earlier in the year
at SpaceX.
I haven't been able to sort of figure out what exactly happened.
Hey, I need a bolt.
Technicians, I like to call them rocket surgeons. It's 100 degrees outside, near 100% humidity, and you know, we've got to get this test off.
With the propellants you're using, with the pressures you're at, there's risk all the time.
You got hydrogen, methane, liquid oxygen. So, yeah, it's essentially a bomb.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Rockets are amazing, right? I mean, we all dreamed about space as kids, didn't we? But people don't usually think much about who builds the rockets. There's this space mirror in Cape Canaveral that honors the 25 astronauts who have died pursuing our space dreams. But that memorial omits those who died building the machines that sent them to space.
An enormous explosion.
Three technicians died building the Spaceship Two in 2007
for Virgin Galactic
when a nitrous oxide tank exploded during a test. There have been a lot of incidents like these over the years. And there was another accident this year, in January, at SpaceX.
I've confirmed that it happened.
But you don't have, like, detail, like, first-hand details or anything?
Nobody who actually witnessed it yet.
Yeah.
Reed had heard about an incident where a technician named Francisco Cabada was hurt. And his friends and family put up this GoFundMe page after the accident, and hundreds of people gave. Most of those who gave their names work for SpaceX, Elon Musk's company that's leading the new space race.
Welcome to SpaceX.
But they're not the only ones racing.
Broke up for a second.
Money is pouring into the private space industry, fueling innovation and fierce competition.
And touchdown.
What you have given me is the most profound experience I can imagine.
It's not all about sending billionaires and William Shatner to Mars. The cost of sending stuff to space has been dropping fast. Sending a kilogram to space on the space shuttle used to cost about $50,000. By 2018, the price was a little under $3,000. On SpaceX's Falcon 9. This is how giant innovations happen, and it all happens in one way. Testing. A lot of testing. We went to NASA's Stennis Center in Mississippi to see testing up close, where a newcomer in this new space race, Relativity, is quickly expanding its testing program. Relativity makes its engines with 3D printing, which helps attract talent.
There's definitely a more innovative kind of culture here. 3D printing is really what sold me. Too much of my professional career was spent like chasing parts.
3D printing allows Relativity to speed up and solve those supply chain issues. The company says it can build a rocket in 60 days.
It's 3D printed, and it's the first one in the world. You know, I think that's what is the big thing for me.
Typically, NASA does 2 to 3 tests a day. Relativity has conducted as many as 14 tests in a day. And it's hard, complicated work that involves a lot of technicians, like senior propulsion test technician Robert Caldwell.
I've always wanted to work on a rocket engine or be in some type of space program.
He's a veteran who worked on fighter jets and helicopters before this.
Sometimes it's going to be 14, 16-hour days, and we rattle off 2 or 3 tests. We're here to test it. If it blows up, good. We know we can't do that anymore. If it doesn't, great.
They're by far the most skilled people, really, about what the engine looks like or what it could look or should look like between tests. We lay on them a lot.
These are private companies, so it's a race against time to keep up with competitors, gain market share, show investors they're making progress. That means a lot more tests, which can mean more danger, like what happened in January at SpaceX.
They had really been just pushing the envelope, you know, if you're not blowing something up, you're not pushing hard enough kind of mentality.
A high production rate solves many ills, Elon Musk tweeted earlier this year. Later, he told the Everyday Astronaut channel, "You can try lots of things, and it's okay if you blow up an engine, because you have a high production rate." After dozens of colleagues donated to Kubota's GoFundMe page, they say they've been left in the dark about what happened. A couple of months later, his sister posted a TikTok, praying for him to come out of his coma. After weeks of calls, our colleague Gina Chan found two reports from regulatory agencies.
The accident investigation summary says an integration technician was performing pneumatic pressure checks on a Raptor V2 engine. The employee was struck by the fuel controller cover. The employee suffered a skull fracture and head trauma and was hospitalized in a coma for months.
All these accidents, they all are categorized. SpaceX codes that as a space industry accident, right? In the Kubota accident, it's an aviation accident. Like, not only are we not going to recognize this person's sacrifice for the space industry, in the official paperwork, he wasn't even working in the space industry.
Still, these accidents are rare. Nobody we talked to for the story suggested that slowing down is the answer. The thing is, these technicians, just like astronauts, they've been dreaming working on this their whole life. They know that testing is dangerous, so they check everything. While we were at Relativity, an apprentice named Jen Peterson found something wrong with an engine.
That's where it is.
Yeah. But that's it right there. You found it.
That's what I thought.
You can only learn so much by reading about it or doing equations. Sometimes things sound really great and then it doesn't actually work so well.
According to both the company and regulators, there haven't been any injuries at Relativity. It has a culture of transparency.
If that's going to happen, you want it to happen in such a way that we learn something from it.
Relativity made a point about being as transparent as possible with us too. But SpaceX apparently isn't up for talking about the accident.
Did SpaceX communicate back to you at all?
It's been radio silence from then. If something bad happened to an astronaut during a test, you know, at SpaceX or whatever, like, they'd be talking about it.
It's easy to appreciate the risk and heroism of strapping yourself to a rocket. It's a shame that anyone would have to hide the heroism it takes to build one. Nobody that knew about the accident felt comfortable being named or filmed for the story either. Kubota's GoFundMe page used to show a photo of him wearing a SpaceX t-shirt. Now, there are no references to the company.
I just got an 11th hour call from the attorney representing the Kubotas. How can we describe this? Like, is he, you know, not able to communicate, or he's been in hospital care for this whole time, the whole year, and he's still in inpatient care? You know, the likelihood is he'll never work again.
According to an attorney for the family and Kubota's brother-in-law, it's unclear whether he'll ever be able to leave the hospital. Relativity is getting close to its first launch in Florida, where the Space Mirror Memorial is. But first, these tests need to go well.
That's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Play to win the game.